It's so important that we as Kanaka o Ke Kai make that connection to Mauka and send our mana to Maunakea, because we are Pai Aina o Hawaii, and there's no separation from island, there's no separation from Ahupua'a. We all need to come together as a Lahui as we have. So thank you guys.
Together they had Maunakea. Wakea Sky Father and Papahanao Moku, mother of most of our islands, they come together and they have Ho'ohoku Kalani, the star realm, the goddess of the star realm. Wakea and Ho'ohoku Kalani, they come together and I'm Halo Nakalau Kapalili, Wahanao Ia Helopa. Halo Nakalau Kapalili, born stillborn and buried at the east of the house, and out came the first kalo, our first food. Wakea and Ho'ohoku Kalani come together again and have haloa, the first kanaka. Haloa meaning eternal breath, a long breath. From haloa comes the lahui kanaka, comes the Hawaiian people. And we see in this genealogy that we are connected directly to Maunakea. Mauna Awakea is our ancestor. If you have Hawaiian blood, if you are Koko Hawaii, within your blood, your DNA is the mountain. How could you not remember your power after you know that? Your mana, your connection to aina. After I learned that chant, I never questioned my ea again. I never questioned my individual sovereignty again after I knew that genealogy. If you are not Hawaiian, but you live here, or if you're visiting and you have drank of this water, you've eaten the food of this land, you have the same responsibility as all of us to care and to stand up and show up and speak up for this place that loves all of us, that feeds all of us. Mauna Awakea is calling to the hearts so many people around the world right now for water, to remember water and our importance and connection. mountains. Our mountains carry our water. And so our ancestors teach us that we can't just care about ourselves at this time, that our children and the children after them, they will be drinking of the water that we protect, the water that we care for. So we're not just standing for right now. We're standing for the next 7 generations because they matter. What kind of earth are we leaving them? Are we leaving Papa better than we found her? We are seeing that we are now all setting our intentions to do that work together. No matter our skin color or background, we all are coming together now. Because Papa is calling on us. Mauna Awakea is calling on us to stand in kapu aloha, a firm commitment to what is pono, to what is just, to what is true. Halimakua, an elder of ours from Hawaii Island who has since passed on. Before he left, he passed on this knowledge of kapu aloha. It was so beautiful and so clear. And he would say, love all you see with humility. Live all you feel with reverence. That's an important one, yeah? And know all that you possess with discipline. Kapu aloha is a practice. It is self-discipline. To live all we feel with reverence. That means the anger and the rage that may come, because that's true, we're human. And what is happening to our home and the world is terrifying sometimes. It's sad to see the Amazon on fire. It's not just sad. It's not just that. People deliberately started those fires out of ignorance and greed. It's devastating. And so we can get mad sometimes, enraged sometimes, if we can feel that with reverence, that changes the way that we move in the world, yeah? And so if we can feel every single one of these emotions and let our mana and our strength embrace us at the same time, we can learn how to stand with discipline. Because our kapu aloha is also our safety. We cannot just throw out all of these really heavy emotions out there, out of everything that we're feeling. We're also protecting a mountain, but protecting ourselves as well. To keep our kupuna safe on the front line. To keep the women in the mana wahine line safe. So kapu aloha is also our protection. And so right now, I just want to lift those kupuna. Those first 30-something kupuna who were arrested in the first beginning weeks. Lift them up and bring them right here to this circle right now. Kupuna that stood for Wahakuloa, for Kaho'olawe, for Makua. Kupuna that still stand. Want to lift up Uncle Ku Ching and Auntie Max Kahaulilio. They want in the Supreme Court a victory in the Supreme Court for the military to clean up their mess at Wahakuloa. That is huge for us. I hope that we're celebrating these victories, Pukala Nakila, because these are the things that help us move forward. That victory, doesn't that make you want to stand a little taller? More strong in your core? Doesn't that make you feel like you are standing as strong as a mountain? It makes me feel that way too. I want to lift up all of those petitioners for the past 10 years. In all of those contested case hearings, if those petitioners didn't contest the TMT, that building would have been on the Mauna already. So for the past 10 years, this first 6 petitioners, Mauliola, the next 16 petitioners, Mauliola, the first 31 arrests on the mountain in 2015, Mauliola, and all the arrests after that, Mauliola. There was always opposition to these telescopes from the 1960s until now. Someone was always saying, no, this is not new. Now the world is saying no with us. How powerful is that? So I want to just tell you where kukiaimauna comes from before I teach you this one protocol hula written by my mom and before we start our official aha for this here beautiful ceremony from Mauka to Makai. Kukiaimauna comes from our living room when we were writing a chant for the Mauna in 2013. We were writing a chant that would remind us how to continue to stay strong through all of this. So it was based on ku, to stand. And my mom turned to me and she said, what can we say for stand strong like a mountain? Stand strong as a protector of a mountain. And I thought of my kupuna's name from Kohala. Umi hulu mako kalani kia imauna o abini. There's a lot of wisdom, a lot of wisdom in our kupuna's names. Come from a long line of protectors of mountains. Because we're writing a ku chant, I just listened to my tutu and said, kukia imauna. And that has since grown in its depth for me as I was sitting just on this front line and looking at the Mauna. We're talking about how Ka'ahumanu made her body a pu'uhonua, just like we created a pu'uhonua at Pu'uhuluhulu, a safe place, a protected place. I thought about when the kupuna say, ah, ku oi ko mama, ku oi ko papa. You look just like your mom, you look just like your dad, you're just like them. How you embody that. And then I thought of kukiaimauna. We now embody and invoke the protection of Maunakea with our very ea, the very breath, the very descendant of haloa, that breath that comes out of this here waha and back again, that breath of life. We embody the protection of Maunakea from wherever we are. So when you say kukiaimauna all the way from here, just your very being is protecting Maunakea. Your very intention, just saying the name Maunakea at 6 a.m., 8 a.m., 12 noon, 8 p.m., all the times that we are in aha, that is casting protection and love to Maunakea and to the kia'i on the front line. So know that you matter. Even if you cannot come to the Mauna, that your very support and solidarity is everything. It has mana. Thank you. From Hawaii Nuiakea, from Hawaii Mokupuni, from Maunakea all the way to Kauai. Mahalo nui for the way that you stand. Kukiaimauna. Kukiaimauna. Kukiaimauna.
Thank you.
I also wanted to say a huge thank you to every single department that's helped make this all happen today. Our water safety. I want to thank Fern, who's been kind of watching over us this whole time and helping us. All of our crew who have graciously donated their time to give us our ike that we're going to get today. So make sure you stick around for classes after the paddle out. And then I also want to thank Havane and Asia for coming from the Mauna.
Asia come up a little bit. Okay, and so you're gonna clap three times and you're gonna ummi to your right. Trust, there's people, there's bradas on the Mauna that I never thought I would see doing this. So if they can, you guys can. Okay, Pillar. Hi, Auntie.
Hi.
Hi, aunties. Oh my God, these are my aunties. Okay, I'm gonna go hug them right after this. Okay.